Hello and welcome, I'm Raghav, and in this session we are going to see how we can create fake REST APIs for testing, and this is going to be very easy and very interesting. A prerequisite for this session is we should be having Node.js installed on our system because the software we are going to use is a Node.js program. So in case you want to check if Node.js is installed on your system or not, you can go to your command line, or in case you are on Mac operating system, you can go to your terminal and run the command node space hyphen v or node space hyphen hyphen version, both will work. And if you get a version of Node.js, that means it is installed. You can also say npm minus v or npm space hyphen hyphen version to check the node package manager version. The same thing, if I am on Windows, I can say node space hyphen v or npm space hyphen v, and in my case it is installed. Just in case Node.js is not installed on your system, you can go and check for node.js download, and this will take you to the node.js.org download site, and here you will find the installers and you can get the installer for your operating system and install Node.js. So once you have done this, then we will start with our step number one, which is we will install JSON Server. So JSON Server is the program that we are going to use for creating a local API server and then create a local API. So this is the link, this is the GitHub link for JSON Server, and if you go here, you can see there is some documentation. So this can be used to create a full fake REST API without any coding. And here you can see this documentation, and then here is the command to install JSON Server, and as I said, it is a node program, so therefore we are having this npm install -g JSON Server. So I'll copy this and paste it on my command line, and you can use the -g option to install this globally on this system. Otherwise you can just say npm install JSON Server and hit enter. This will download and install JSON Server. So in my case it was already there, and here I'm getting some warnings, which is fine. You should not be getting any errors. And then once this is done, you can start JSON Server using this command JSON Server hyphen hyphen watch db.json. Now here db.json is a JSON file where we will have our API data. Now if you do not already create db.json, it will create the file with some dummy data, and it will create the file at the same location from where you run this command. So in my case it is cusers administrator, and this is step number two. We will run and start JSON Server. So let me copy this command and paste it on my command prompt, and let me paste it here. So I'll copy it again and run it. So you can see it has started. Also it says because db.json was not existing, it has created db.json with some default data, and this is the URL from where we can invoke JSON Server from our browser. So before I go to this HTTP localhost 3000, let me go to my folder cusers administrator, and I am here, and you can see a file is created, db.json. I will open this file into some editor like Notepad++, and here is the file. And also let me go to my browser, and here I will go to, and you can see this is the data. So when I go to localhost 3000, I should see these resources. We have posts, comments and profile. So I'm going to my browser and I will go to localhost 3000, and you can see it says you are successfully running JSON Server, and here are the resources. We have posts, comments and profile. I can click here, or I can go to the URL and say /posts and hit enter, and you can see it is showing me the posts that is here. Similarly, I can see comments, and here is the comment, and I can see profile as well. Now I am going to create some dummy API data right from scratch that you can use for testing on REST Assured, or you can use it for any other purposes. So I will go to my db.json file and I will remove everything, and now I'm going to create a fresh data. So I will start with a curly bracket start and stop, and then I will create a resource for users. So I will say within quotes, I will say users and a colon and square bracket start and square bracket stop, and within this square brackets I can create data for users. So let me start with, I will give a curly bracket start and stop, and within this curly brackets I can give the data for the user. So I can say first name and I can give some value, comma, I can say last name, and let me give some, I will give tab here so that I can see the proper indentation here. And I will give the last name, comma, and here I will give a subject ID. So what I'm going to do is I will also be creating an array for subjects, and then I can do a relationship between users and subjects, and I will show you in a moment how to do that. So let me say subject ID is one here, and also let me give ID for the user. I will say ID is one, this is user ID one, and this is our first user. And let me save this and check. If I go to localhost 3000 now, and you can see now I'm getting a users resource. Just in case you do not get this, make sure that your syntax is correct. You can also go to your command line, and in case there will be any issue, you will see it here, like a syntax problem. So syntax is important here. So if I go to localhost 3000 /users, I should be getting my user details here, and that is what I'm getting here. So this is working fine. Let me create one more user. I will copy this, give a comma here and paste it. And here I will give one more user. I will say Henry. I will say Ford. I will give the subject ID 2 here and user ID as well 2, and one more user. So I will say this is Graham Bell. Here let me keep the subject ID to 1 and the user ID to 2, 3. Save this and check again on the browser. So now I have 3 users. So I have a users resource and I have 3 users. Now I will create a resource for subjects. So here, after the square bracket is closed for the first resource or the first array, I will give a comma, and then I will say a new array. I'll give subjects here, and then a colon and a square bracket start and a square bracket close, and inside the square brackets I will give the data. So I will give a curly bracket start and stop, and then I will give the name of the subject. I will say name is, let us say, automation, comma, and ID is 1, and I'll copy this and create one more subject. So this here I will say name, let us say DevOps, and ID is 2. So I have created 2 subjects in the subjects resource. I will save and check. If I go to localhost 3000. So here I am getting subjects resource as well. If I go to localhost 3000 / subjects, and here I am getting the two subjects. Now I can also say / subjects / 1, and if I hit enter, I am getting only the data of subject with ID 1. And if I say / subjects / 1 and / users, so this should give me all the users that have subject 1. If I hit enter, you can see I am getting these two users that have subject ID 1. So this is how you can check. And I can also say, suppose I say subjects question mark name equals automation. So here I am getting only the subject that has name automation. So I can use these parameters as well. So now we have created our dummy REST API, and on a local server and on our local system, we are able to host and run it. Now in the next session, I will show you exactly how we can do testing on this API using different HTTP methods using REST Assured. So we have also invoked the JSON server URL on the browser, and this is what we can do now. We have our API ready, a local API, and we will do testing in the next session. I hope this session was useful for you. Thank you for watching.